On Tuesday, the Commission on Security and Cooperation in Europe, also known as U.S. Helsinki Commission, strongly urged the Azerbaijani government to fulfill its obligations on human rights and democracy. Azerbaijan is at crossroads. One road leads forward towards democracy and economic prosperity, while the other leads to authoritarianism, corruption, and economic decline. This fourth presidential election will be a significant opportunity for Azerbaijan to act on its choice, said Dr. Paul M. Carter, senior State Department advisor to the U.S. Commission on Security and Cooperation in Europe, at a special briefing on troubled partner, growing authoritarianism in Azerbaijan. Speaking of October's election, Carter stressed that all the presidential candidates must be able to act independently and to run their election campaign without fearing persecution or detention. Journalists must enjoy freedom in reporting on elections without any threat, such as detention on trumped-up charges, financial pressure, or blockage of broadcasting. NGOs, religious organizations, and other elements of civil society must be allowed to operate freely without any concocted legal restrictions. And Azerbaijani society must be able to trust that the government is transparent and rules best-mannered in the interests of all, not in the interests of one group, Dr. Carter added. Other speakers were Thomas Miller, State Department's Deputy Assistant Secretary for Democracy, Human Rights and Labor, Dr. Miriam Lenskoy, Director for Russia and Eurasia at the National Endowment for Democracy, Erkin Gadrilli from Real Movement, and Eldar Namazov from National Council of Democratic Forces. Azerbaijani government was represented by the delegation led by member of Azerbaijani Parliament Samet Saidov and the country's ambassador to the U.S. Elin Suleymanov. Two more MPs, Sevinch Fetaliyeva and Asim Molazadeh, along with embassy staff were present at the auditorium backed by the government supporters. Meanwhile, the discussion managed to raise several main concerns, such as Ilham Aliyev's running for presidency for the third time, Rustam Ibrahimbekov's harassment, suppression of media and youth activists, etc. Saidov snapped at the criticisms, saying that President Aliyev has recently signed a special action plan to improve the human rights situation in the country. Democratic forces in Azerbaijan are trying to unite. Who created this environment? The opposition is sitting together with us. Is this what you call an authoritarian regime? Asked Saidov. The government has to keep promises to invite election observers from the OCODIHR, release detained politicians such as Ilgar Mammadov, investigate human rights violations and encourage real dialogue with civil society, State Department's Deputy Assistant Secretary Thomas Miller emphasized. In the meantime, he reaffirmed that Washington does not take any side, and it's up to Azerbaijani people to decide their future.